Thomas. It's
honey, it's Blaine's birthday.
Now where is she?
In the bathroom.
Washing out the things?
I reckon so.
How long has she been in there?
All afternoon.
Soaking in the hot tub.
Yes.
Temperature's 100 on the nose and she's soaking in the hot tub.
She says it cools off for the evening.
And you go out and get her coax, I suppose, and serve them to her majesty in the tub. And sit down here.
Stanley, I've got
sit down.
To
I got the dope on your big sister, Stella.
Stanley, stop picking on Lance.
The girl calls me college.
You are doing all you can lately to rub her the wrong way.
So I've been told, and told, and told, and told. You know she's been feeding us a pack of lies here.
No, I don't, and I don't want to hear it.
Oh, she has, however. But now, the cat's out of the bag. I found out some things.
What things?
Things that I already expected, but now I have proof from the most reliable sources which I've checked on.
Hello, Stanley.
Some canary bird, huh?
Now please tell me quietly, what it is you think you've heard about my sister?
Lie number one. All this squeamishness she puts on. You should hear the line she's been feeding to Mitch. You know, he thinks she's never been more than kissed by a fella, and you know Sister Blanche ain't no lily.
What have you heard and who from?
Our supply man. Down at the plant. It's been going through Laurel for years and knows all about her. And everybody else in the town of Laurel knows all about her. She's as famous in Laurel as if she was the president of the United States, except she's not respected by any party. And the supply man, he goes to a hotel called the Flamingo.
What about the Flamingo?
She stayed there too. This was after the place had slipped through her lily white fingers. She moved to the Flamingo, a second class hotel, which has the advantages of not interfering with the private social lives of the personalities there. The Flamingo's used to all kinds of going on, but even the management at the Flamingo was impressed by Dame Blanche. In fact, they were so impressed that they asked her to turn in her room key for permanently. And this happened a couple weeks before she showed here. And sure, I can see how you're upset by all this. Now she pulled the wool over your eyes as much as Mitch's.
No, it's pure invention. There is not a word, a truth.
Honey, I told you. I checked on every single story. The trouble with Jane Blanche was that she couldn't put on her act anymore alone. They got wised up, and after two or three dates, they just quit. And she moves on to another. The same old lines, the same old act, the same old hooing. But the town was too small for this to go on forever, and as time went on, she became known as the town character. Regarded to as not just different, but downright loco. Nuts. For the past year or two, she's been washed up like poison. Now that's why she's here. Visiting royalty, putting on all this act. She was practically told by the mayor to get out of town. Yes. Did you know there was an army camp based near Laurel? And your sister was one of the places called Out of Bounds? So much for being such a refined and particular type of girl. Which brings us to line number two.
I don't want to hear anymore.
She didn't just resign temporarily because of her nerves. I'm so rebobbed she didn't. She was kicked out before the spring term ended, and I hate to tell you the reason that step had to be taken. A 17-year-old boy she had gotten mixed up with. And when the boy's dad learned of it, he contacted the high school superintendent. And oh, I'd like to have been in that office when they called Dame Blanche on the carpet. I'd like to have seen her try to squirm her way out of that one, but they had her hooked good and proper, and she knew the jig was all up. They told her she better move on to some fresh territory. There was practically a town ordinance passed against her.
dare fight it.
She was young. Very young. She married a boy who wrote poetry. He was extremely good looking. I think she didn't just love him. Worshipped the ground he walked on. Adored him. Thought him almost too fine to be human. Then she found out.
What?
This beautiful and intelligent young man was a degenerate. Then your supply man give you that information?
All we discussed was recent history. It must have been a pretty long time ago.
Yeah, it was a pretty long time ago.
How many candles you sticking in that cake?
I will stop at 25.
Who's company expected?
Well, I invited Mitch over for cake and ice cream.
No, don't expect Mitch over tonight.
Why?
Stella, Mitch is a buddy of mine. We worked in the same outfit together, 241st Engineer. Worked on the same plant, and now on the same ball.
Stan, did you repeat what that?
You're damn right I told him. I'd have that on my conscience for the rest of my life if I knew all that stuff and let my best friend get caught.
Is Mitch through with her?
Well, wouldn't you be?
I said, is Mitch through with her?
No, not exactly through with her, just wised up.
Stanley! Blanche thought that Mitch was going to want to marry her. I was hoping so too.
Well, he's not going to marry her now. Maybe he was, but he's not gonna jump in a tank with a school of sharks. Blanche! Oh, Blanche, can I please get in my bathroom?
Yes, please, sir. Could you wait 1 second?
Oh, well, having waited 1 hour, I guess 1 second ought to pass in her.
She hasn't got a job. What will she do?
She's not staying here past Tuesday. You know that, don't you? Just to be sure, I bought her a ticket. A bus ticket.
Well, in the first place, Blanche wouldn't go on a bus.
Well, she'll go on a bus, right?
No, she won't. No, she won't stay.
She'll go! Period! P.S. She'll go Tuesday.
What will she do? What on earth will she do?
My future's mapped out for her.
What does that mean?
Hey, Canary Bird! Toots! Get out of the bathroom!
Thank you. Brother Stanley. Tell us a funny story, make us all laugh. I don't know what's the matter. You're all so solemn and... Oh, is it because I got stood up by my beau? You know, it's my first time in all my experience with men, and I've had many of all sorts that, never been stood up by anybody. I don't know how to take it. So go on, Stanley, tell us a story. Tell us a funny story to help us out.
I didn't think you liked my stories, Blanche.
Well, I like them when they're amusing, but not indecent.
I don't think I know you refined enough for your taste.
Let me tell them?
Yes. You used to know lots of good stories, Blanche?
Yes. Alright, let me run through my repertoire. I love parrot stories. Do you all love parrot stories? Alright, this one is about the old maid and the parrot. You see, this old maid, she had a parrot that cursed on Blue Street. Right, he knew more vulgar expressions than Mr. Stanley here. And, the only way to hush the bird up was to go back and put the cover on the cage. You think it was nighttime, go back to sleep. And, one day the old maid had just uncovered the parrot for the day when who should be coming up the walk but the preacher. Ooh. And so she rushed back and put the cover on the bird and then let the preacher in. And, upstairs. But then the bird was quiet as a mouse. But just when the old maid was asking the preacher how much sugar he wanted in his coffee, the bird broke the silence with, "God damn, that was a short day."
Don't ever talk to me that way. Pig. Disgusting. Vulgar. Greasy. Your words have been on your tongue and your sisters for 2 months around here. Now who do you two think you are, pair of queens? Remember what Huey Long said. Every man is king, and I'm king around here, so don't you forget it! My place is clear. You want me to your place?
While I was bathing. No, I think you know. You know why Mitch didn't show up tonight, but you're not telling me. I'm gonna call him.
I wouldn't.
No, I'm gonna call him on the phone.
I wish you wouldn't.
Well, I intend to be given some explanation from somebody.
Oh, please, with your doings. I never had so much trouble swallowing food in my life, looking at that girl's face and the empty chair.
Yes, I would like to speak to Mr. Mitchell, please.
Oh, I am so sorry. I would like to leave my number, if I may. Yes, it's Magnolia 9047. Yes, and could you tell him that it is very important to call back? Yes, very important. Thank you.
Steph, it's gonna be all right. After she goes and after you've had the baby, it's gonna be all right between me and you. The way it was.
You remember the way it was? The nights we had together. God, honey, it's gonna be sweet when we can make noise in the night and get them color lights going. I
got somebody's sister behind the curtain to hear us. Steve, Eunice. Back to Laurel on the Greyhound Tuesday.
Wasn't we happy together? Wasn't it all okay before she showed up?
let you in here after the treatment that I received from you this evening. So, utterly uncavalier. Hello, beautiful. My, what the cold shoulder and uncouth apparel. You haven't even shaved. But I forgive you. I forgive you because it is such a relief to see you. You've stopped that awful poking tune in my head. Have you ever had anything talk in your head? No, of course you haven't, you dumb angel puss. You never get anything caught in your head.
Do we have to have the phantom?
No.
I don't like fans.
Well, then, let's turn it off. I'm not possible through this. I don't know what we have to drink around here. I haven't investigated.
I don't want Stan's liquor!
Not Stan's! You know, some things on the premises are actually mine. Is your mother well? Has your mother mentioned?
Why?
There's something the matter tonight, but I won't cross-examine the witness. I will just pretend that I didn't notice anything different about you. That music again.
What music?
The polka tune that they were playing the night that Alan... Shot. Yes, shot. It always stops after the shot. Stop now.
Are you boxed out of your mind?
I'm gonna go see what we have in terms of... Oh! Please! Oh, God. Please forgive me for being so undressed. I've practically given up on you. Had you forgotten your invitation to supper?
I wasn't gonna see you no more.
Wait, I can't hear you, and you say so little that when you do say something, I wanna hear every syllable of it. What was I looking for? Oh, yeah, liquor. Yes, you know, I think I am boxed out of my mind. We've had so much excitement here tonight. Oh, look, what is this, I wonder? Southern comfort. I wonder, what is that?
Well, if you don't know, it must belong to Stan.
Get your foot off the bed. Get it off! It has a curtain cover on it! Of course, you man, you don't notice things like that. I have done so much with this place. I've been here.
I bet you have.
I have. You saw it before I came. Look at it now. It's sort of dainty. I would like to keep it that way.
Aren't you leaving pretty soon now?
I wonder if this ought to be mixed with something. Ooh, sweet. Yes, it's very sweet. Why, it's, look, it's a liqueur, I believe. Yes, it's a liqueur. Oh, you're probably not gonna like it, but you might wanna try it.
I told you already I don't want no Stan's liquor, and I mean it. You want to lay off his liquor? He says you've been laughing it up all summer like a wildcat.
What a fantastic statement! Fantastic of him to say it, and fantastic of you to repeat it. I am not going to lower myself to the level of such cheap accusations that answer them even. What? I see something there in your eyes. What's in your mind?
Well, it's dark in here.
I like the dark. It's comforting to me.
I ain't seen you in the light, and that's a fact.
Is it?
I never seen you in the afternoon.
Well, Mitch, you have to play in the afternoon.
Not Sunday afternoon. You never want to go out until after 6. And it's always some place that's not light much.
Wait, there's some obscure meaning in this, but I'm just failing to catch
it. What it means is I never had a real good look at you, Blanche. Let's turn on the light in here.
Wait, what light was on?
This one with a paper thing on it.
What? No! Oh, what did you do that for?
So I can take a look at you in the plane.
What? So you don't mean to be so insulted?
No, just realistic.
I don't want realism. I want magic.
Yeah. Magic.
Magic. I do misrepresent things to people. I don't tell the truth, but I tell you what ought to be the truth. And if that is a sin, then let me be damned for it. Wait, don't turn on that light!
Hiding myself away from the world in.
other things like blood-stained pillow slips. Mother had linen needs changing, but couldn't we get a colored girl to do it? No. No, God, we couldn't ever, thank God.
Lordy.
But I used to sit here. She used to sit there. Death was as close as you are.
Count on us.
We've never even heard of it.
Coronas para los muertos.
Death.
Flores.
The opposite is desire.
Flores para los muertos.
So do you wonder?
Huh.
Of course you wonder.
Coronas.
Back at Belle Reve, where we lost Belle Reve, there was an army camp that trained young soldiers. At night they would go out on the town and come back and show up on my lawn. Come. Blanche. The old deaf lady remaining never suspected a thing. Sometimes I would go out and answer their calls. And later the paddy wagon would gather them up like daisies along the home. Wait, what do you want?
What I've been missing all summer.
Oh, then marry me, marry.
No! You are not clean enough to bring it to the house with my mother!
Right, you left before my wire came in.
You got a
telegram from an old admirer of mine.
That's up.
Yes, it's an invitation.
Where to?
A cruise on the Caribbean on a yacht.
Well, well, what do you know?
I've never been so surprised in my life.
I guess not.
It was like a shot from the blue.
And who'd you say it was from?
An old beau of mine.
Oh, the one that gave you the white fox pieces.
Yes, yes, Mr. Shep Huntley. I hadn't seen him again until last Christmas. Yeah, met him on Biscayne Boulevard. Now, this telegram. Oh, you know the problem is clothes, so I torn to my trunk to see what I had that's suitable for the tropics.
You came up with that gorgeous diamond tiara.
Oh, no, there's something. It's only rhinestones.
Gosh, I thought it was Tiffany's diamonds.
Anyhow, I shall be entertained in style.
Just goes to show you, you never know what's coming.
Yes. Just when I thought my luck had begun to fail me.
Yeah, pops this Miami millionaire.
No, this man is not from Miami. This man is from Dallas.
Oh, this man is from Dallas?
Yes, this man is from Dallas, where gold sprouts from the ground.
Well, just so he's from somewhere.
Oh, no, please close the curtain before you undress any further.
This is all I'm gonna address for now. Seen the bottle opener? You know, I used to have this cousin could open a beer bottle with his teeth. That was his only accomplishment, all he could do. He was just a human bottle opener. And then one day, at a wedding party, he broke his front teeth off. After that, he was so embarrassed of himself, he would sneak out of the house when company came. Oh. Woo! Rain from heaven! Hey, what do you say, Blanche? We bury the hatchet? Make it another cup?
No.
I'll get with it, Blanche.
What are you doing in here?
And I like to break out on special occasions like this. The silk pajamas I wore on my wedding night. And when that phone rings and they say, "You got a son," I'll tear it off and wave it like a flag. I guess we're both entitled to put on the dog. You with your oil millionaire and me having a baby.
No, and I think of having things such as privacy again.
Oh, this millionaire from Dallas. Is it gonna interfere with your privacy?
No, it is not the kind of thing that you are thinking of. This man is a gentleman. He respects me. He wants from me is my companionship. Great wealth can sometimes make a person lonely. But a woman, a cultivated woman, of intelligence and breeding, she can enrich a man's life immeasurably. Physical beauty. It's a passing state. A transitory possession. But beauty of the mind. Tenderness of the spirit. And richness of the heart. I have all of those things. Not fade with the years, but grow. You know, I find it funny that I should be called a destitute woman when I have all of these treasures locked in my heart. But I have been foolish. for being a vicious slander to me.
Stories that he had gotten from
you. I gave him his walking papers.
Oh, you did, huh?
Yeah. But then he came back. Came back with a box of roses to beg my forgiveness. Oh, he implored my forgiveness. But some things are not forgivable. Deliberate cruelty is not forgivable. Is the one unforgivable thing, in my opinion, and the one thing that I have never, ever been guilty of. But I said to him, I said, thank you, but it was foolish of ourselves to ever think that we could adapt ourselves to each other. Our ideals and backgrounds are just too different. We have to be realistic about such things. So farewell, my friend, and no hard feelings.
Was this before or after the telegram from Texas?
Wait, what telegram? No, it was after. As a matter of fact.
There was no telegram at all. There is no oil millionaire, and Mitch didn't come back here with no roses because I know where he is. No, there isn't a damn thing but pure imagination, lies, conceit, and tricks. And look at yourself. Look at yourself in that worn-out Mardi Gras outfit rented for 50 cents from some rag picker. No, I've been on to you from the start. No once did you pull the wool over this boy's eyes. You know, you come in here and you sprinkle the place with powders and spray perfumes and you cover light bulbs with paper lanterns. And lo and behold, the place is turned into Egypt and you're a queen of the Nile. Sitting on your throne, swilling down my liquor. Well, I say, ha, ha. You hear me? I said, ha, ha, ha. Get by me? Sure.
plenty of room to get by me now.
Don't know if you stand in there. I've got to get out somehow.
What? You think I'll let the film with you? Come to think of it, maybe you wouldn't be so bad to interfere with.
No, you, dear. Still closer up.
What?
Something awful will happen in real. No, please
down.
Don't. Don't! I'm in danger!
What'd you do that for?
Oh, I could twist the broken end in your face.
Oh, I bet you would do that.
Oh, I would! Oh, I would!
Oh, you want to rough out? All right, let's have some rough out.
With the bunch of artificial
did the right thing.
What else could you do?
I couldn't believe the story when living with Stanley.
Don't you ever believe it. You've got to keep on going, honey. No matter what happens, we've all got to keep on going.
Stella, is the coast clear?
Yes, it's clear.
Close those curtains before I come out.
They're closed.
Hey, Mitch.
Washed my hair.
Did you play it?
Yes. I don't think I got all the soap out.
Such fine hair.
No. It's a problem. Didn't I get a call?
Who from? Where?
Chef. Huntley, of course.
Well, not yet.
The house straight.
Hey, Mitch! Come to!
At the door. Maybe it's me, huh?
Doctor? Yes. Just
she dressed like?
Just a plain tailored sort of outfit. I wonder if she's on.
Are you ready to go, Blanche?
Yes, I am ready to go. How do I look?
Lovely, lovely.
Do we have to go through that room?
Well, I'll go with you, honey.
Don't get up. I'm only passing through.
You want the ladder?
No!
Hey, you got any seconds?